Hey everybody, it's Norm from Test It.
And Kishore from Test It.
And Kishore, we are thrilled to present with you a new series demonstrating some great things with science.
Yeah, there's amazing demonstrations that you can do that showcase all of the fundamental principles of chemistry, physics, biology. They're all well within reach. You remember those demos that you used to see in high school?
Yeah, it's like magic. The scientists would come in, make something explode, basically Heisenberg from Breaking Bad.
So we're hoping to show some of those for you over the course of this series and a little bit of behind the process to put these together, because they're oftentimes really simple endeavors with really wonderful outputs.
Well, we're privileged to have with us Zeke Kossover from the Exploratorium, which is a great institution in San Francisco, one of the first science museums.
It's one of the preeminent science museums in all of the world, and it's a museum of science, art, and human perception. They maintain a library of all of these science activities that you can do at home with your kids, and at the same time, they train a whole host of teachers on how to do and teach better science in the classroom.
Well, you're going to chat with Zeke, and please enjoy this simple feat of science.
Welcome, Zeke. Zeke is a teacher at the Exploratorium, which is a museum of science, art, and human perception. And you've brought something for us to experiment with today. What are we looking at here?
So this is a vacuum cannon.
Cannon.
Yeah, that's okay. The origin of the vacuum cannon was that I was a high school teacher for many years, and the school wouldn't buy me a pool table for my classroom. I was taught physics, and there's all sorts of cool physics that you can do with a pool table, but they wouldn't get me one. And when I asked them why they wouldn't get me one, it wasn't that it was too expensive or anything. They said they were afraid that the kids would throw the pool balls at each other or hit each other with the pool cubes. And I'm like, what? And they were saying, nope, you can't have one. And then a couple of years later, they bought the kids a ping pong table.
Because ping pong tables are safe, because ping pongs are safe.
Right. You can throw a ping pong ball at someone pretty much as hard as you'd like, and it won't hurt them. Like, even if you like give it the biggest slam you got, it won't hurt anybody. And the reason is that the ping pong ball, for its size, has a lot of air resistance. They're about 2.5 grams, and they're fairly largest for 2.5 grams, so the wind resistance slows them down super fast. So like, even if you were like to hit it at 60 miles an hour, by the time it gets to the other side of the table, it's only going like 10 miles an hour. So it slows down so much that you can't hurt anyone with it. And so that's why they got them a ping pong table.
So is there a way to speed up a ping pong?
Well, so if the problem with a ping pong ball is that the air resistance slows it down so much, then the solution is getting rid of the air. And that's why this is a vacuum cannon. So what we have here is a vacuum pump, and I'm going to draw the air out of the tube.
And this is just a PVC tube?
Yeah, this is a clear PVC. Let me set it up. So we can put the ping pong ball into the tube like this, roll it to the end, and then we'll seal up the ping pong ball with some Mylar. This is the stuff they use for emergency blankets. Don't tell anyone at the Exploratorium that I stole their emergency blanket.
I think they might learn about this somehow.
But this isn't going out to anyone, I'm sure. And then we need a target, and we'll use this can. And then I can seal up this other side down here as well.
And how tight of a fit is the ball in this tube?
So what's really lucky is that this tube is about 41 millimeters on the inside, and the ping pong ball is 40 millimeters. So it's a very tight fit on the inside of the tube, so that it just barely fits down the tube. Any more, it would get stuck, any less, and then it wouldn't make it as tight a fit.
So you said the word cannon, which to me imparts lots of energy is gonna hit that can.
So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna take the air out of the tube, and then I'm gonna puncture the end of the tube, and air is going to rush in. So air pressure is about 14.5 pounds per square inch, and the tube is about 3 square inches on the inside. So about 45 pounds of force is going to push on 2.5 grams of ping pong ball.
You're mixing weights, but it's okay.
Yeah. And so it's going to push on the ping pong ball, and the ping pong ball is going to get shoved forward. Now, normally, if you try to push a ping pong ball really hard, it can't go very fast because of air resistance. But there's no air, or very little air, on the front side of the ping pong ball. So it can be pushed incredibly hard, and it can fly down to the end of the tube. And if everything goes according to plan, it can be going 500 miles an hour by the time it gets to the end.
500 miles an hour, that's like speed of sound level. Almost.
Yeah, we're getting close to the speed of sound.
Well, I'm going to get out of the way, because speed of sound sounds really fast, and I'm really close to the Coke can right now, and let you run the experiment.
Yeah. So it's very loud, so I'm going to put on some earmuffs. And it takes about 30 seconds for it to pump completely down. So now we're pumping it down, pulling the air out. And then I'm going to close this valve so that when the air rushes in, it doesn't go into the vacuum pump. All right, let's count this down. 3, 2, 1.
Whoa. So here's our friendly ping pong ball that's now been cleaved in half.
They don't make them like they used to.
But more importantly, let's take a peek at the can. This wonderful hole is now dramatically in the can. So this hit it with 500 miles an hour coming out of this thing.
Right.
And so there's basically a perfect vacuum and all of that hits it. Does any air ever get around the ball to slow
right.
it down?
So a little bit gets in front of, so the air as it's rushing down, a little bit of the air can get past the ping pong ball. So there's a limit to how long you can make the tube, because as the air is getting in front of the ping pong ball, then the ping pong ball is going to be slowed down by that air in front of it.
And then with the ends, you use this Mylar, which you use a heating blanket. I've seen it done other times with packing tape. Can you do that?
So packing tape works pretty well, but you need to get the extra wide kind, which is a little hardish to come by. And every so often, the material gets sucked down the tube because you didn't hold it well enough at the end. And if that happens to packing tape, it is a bear to get that out because it sticks to the inside. Whereas the Mylar, you can just blow it on the end and you'll blow the Mylar back out.
Oh, this is fantastic. I see you have a blast shield up, but how important is the blast shield to for safety? I mean, it looked like shards of this was coming off, so it's important to have.
Yeah, you need some sort of blast shield. You can get pieces of polycarbonate at the hardware store. They're very sturdy. You just need to make sure you clamp them down into place.
So here is a simple half-day project to almost break the speed of sound, so to prove all those people wrong that ping pongs can't be harmful.
Exactly.
Thanks so much, Zeke. For people that want more information about you and the Exploratorium, where should they go?
They can go to www.exploratorium.edu, or they can come down and visit us at Pier 15 on the Embarcadero in San Francisco.
And the Exploratorium has a number of different activities online that you can do at home. This is just a taste. Thanks so much, Zeke.
Thank you very much.
All right, Kishore, destroying soda cans with ping pong balls.
It's amazing the power that even something like a ping pong ball can have when you remove air resistance to it. I couldn't believe that it could get up near the speed of sound.
Right.
Speed of sound is something you associate with jet aircraft.
And it's something that, you know, you're creating with a vacuum. It's atmosphere, taking as much atmosphere, pushing it through that tube, smashing it through.
You know what else was surprising about it is the materials that went into this project. We're talking about PVC pipe, talking about a little bit of putty and some plumbing fittings. It's not super complicated materials that went into it. Demonstrate one of the fundamental principles in all of physics, air resistance. And I'm still blown away that I guess you can really do some damage with a ping pong ball.
Awesome. Well, we'll be back with more simple feats of science with Kishore and Zeke. So please subscribe to our YouTube channel, like this video, and leave your comments below, and we'll see you next time.